Hello everyone. Now I'm sure some of you know that Nektar's integration for Logic Pro is second to none, offering hands-on control over the various plugins and parameters from your Nektar Impact LX Plus and Impact LX Mini controllers. We've just updated that for Logic 10.8, and we're going to look at now how we're controlling Logic's live looper grid, but more in a production-based capacity using the clips and scenes mode. The first thing I'm going to do is hold down the shift button and press clips on the controller, which opens up the live loops grid here, also available using this blue indicator here. And when I engage clips mode, you'll see that the 8 clips that sit next to the track that you're producing on are available on the 8 pads. I like to think of these as slots, if you like, musical slots where you can store loops and then audition and arrange them on the fly whilst you're producing. Let's take a look at that. I'm going to engage click and then record to the first clip by tapping the pad. So the pad turned red when I was recording, and it's green to show it's playing back. Once you've recorded a clip, there's useful editing features available by holding the clips button and using the transport controls. Clips and loop will quantize the selected clip. You can duplicate and double the content of your clip by using clips and forward, or half it by using clips and rewind. And another useful one is to overdub with some additional content, clips and record, and then you can record over your content that you've recorded into that clip. Once you reach the end of the clip, it goes back to green, which means, of course, that the record is no longer active. Let's create a new track, Shift an Instrument on Impact LX Mini, not available on the LX Plus, by the way. And I'm going to start a new recording by tapping this pad here. Let's just quantize that. And maybe do another clip in the second slot. Not the best recording, but okay, it's a live demo, so at least you get to see it's live this way. And when you want to go between the clips, just tap the pad that you want to trigger. Yellow means there's content to play, green means it's playing. Now I'm going to go back to the drums, and I'm going to be playing the keys, so the piano part with the keys, but I'm going to use clips and track to offset the selected track for my clips from the one that the keys is doing. So here we've got piano, and up here I've got my drums. So let's just stop that one playing and add a new one. Now, because this is a drummer track, it's going to automatically create and populate a beat. I'm just going to tune that down a little bit. Once I'm happy with that, let's turn that click track off, that's annoying me. Once I'm happy with that, hold shift, tap the pad, and you can tap the next slot, so that's next available empty slot, to duplicate. Now let's crank that one up a little bit and add a few more fill, a bit more percussion. Maybe one more. Okay, over to scenes. In scenes mode, the pads will trigger the whole column of clips. So on each track, clip one is going to be triggered by pressing pad 1 in scenes mode. If I press pad 3, only the drums are playing now because there is no clip available on the melodic track, track 2 here. Back to clips mode. Hold clips and then stop to stop playback of the selected clip that's playing at the time. Now I'm going to go back to the start and I'm going to show you how you can record whilst playing melodic parts with the keys and your drum beats and your arrangements with the pads. Now to do that you need to engage the performance record feature in Logic. And a few things happen when you do that. The first thing is that the focus of recording in this arranger will be from any playing back clip in this grid. The other thing that happens is your enabled track record gets disabled, but that's okay. We can use shift and record to engage and re-engage our track. So as I play the keys, see the piano notes being recorded on track 2. And as I tap the pads, notice the clips, that block on track 1 is also getting recorded. All of this gets recorded directly into the arrangement. And when you press stop, those recorded clips can then be edited just like any other MIDI clip to make those drummer patterns your own. Right, that's it from me. I'm just going to play us out now. See you soon. Thanks for watching.